Representing algebraically no points of intersection. Okay, so I've kind of given you the answer, but what we're going to do is we're going to show this. If we had had this in vector form, we probably could have made some reference to the direction vector and the normal of this. And if the direction vector of this line and the normal, meaning perpendicular to this line, were also perpendicular, that would mean that these two lines are definitely parallel to each other. Okay, but in this case, what we're going to actually do is we're going to take, again, because this is already in parametric form, we're going to take our x, y, and z value, and we're going to plug it in for x, y, and z, same as we did before in the Cartesian plane. Do this one a little quicker this time. So, we're going to get 2 multiplied by 2 plus t minus 5 times 2 plus 2t plus 9 plus 8t minus 6 is equal to 0. We'll quickly jump through that. 4 plus 2t minus 10 minus 10t plus 9 plus 8t minus 6 equals 0. We'll collect our like terms here. Oh, shoot. When we go to carry this out, we end up with our like terms. We're going to collect them here. So we have 2t minus 10t gives us negative 8t plus 8t gives us 0t. 4 minus 10 gives us negative 6 plus 9 is positive 3. Minus 6 is negative 3, is equal to 0. 0t is equal to negative 3. Now, algebraically, this looks like we can't really solve for t. We can't divide negative 3 by 0, okay? So what I want you to think of is, can I multiply, or can I plug a number in for t and multiply it by 0 that it will get me negative 3? It can't be done. So because this can't be done, that means there's no solution to this. And a no solution for us proves that we have a line that is parallel to our plane. Okay? Because there is no solution, these two must be parallel because they'll never cross each other in this case.